Hello again, everyone. Welcome back. My name is Prestige, and today we're going to talk about Willard Wyler's Halloween Scream. Okay, I might have taken that a little bit too far, but October is one of my favorite months of the year. I mean, think about it. We got sweater weather, the leaves are changing color, and pumpkin spice. Even if you're not a white girl, you love it. But I figure since this event has officially been announced, we should go through the content calendar and talk about each and every free item we're going to be getting, and of course, the changes that you're going to see throughout the month of October. Now, I also want to mention that this event started yesterday, and it's going to be running until November 1st, meaning we're only going to be a couple of days away from the release of Call of Duty World War II. It's great to see that Infinity Ward is ending it all with a big bang and doing this awesome event for October. Since we're currently in week one, I figured let's go ahead and start there. Week number one allows us to get this limited time Halloween loot. As you can clearly see, there are two weapon variants, two camouflage patterns, a calling card, and of course, most likely the most sought after item, Neil. You can get him as a customization piece for Synaptic for the body and of course the head. I ended up actually pulling him after the second drop, and as you can clearly see here on his back, it says kick me, and it's a pretty cool character nonetheless. I think that out of everything pictured here, this is what many people are going to be going for. As for the weapon variants in week number one, we have, of course, the rare NV4 and, of course, the rare Model 2187. The camouflage pattern really isn't much to me. I really don't care. Same with the perks. There are better weapons to use. In fact, if you've been playing for the entirety of the year, you definitely have better weapons to use. The two camouflage patterns, though, they're actually pretty decent. The first one being Jack-O-Lantern and the second one being Haunted. Both of these are animated. I have Jack-O-Lantern on the launchers. It looks really nice on the Venom X. And of course, Haunted looks pretty good on my Rack 9 Smoothbore, which is what I'm using in this particular gameplay. Moving on to week number two, we have a similar setup. Two more weapon variants, the RPR Evo and the KBS Longbow. Two more weapon camouflages. The first one kind of looks like blood and guts. It's kind of disgusting. It almost makes me wonder if the blood's going to be dripping off of the weapon. I don't think we've ever seen that before, but it would be pretty cool to see. And then the second camo, which I think looks even better, reminds me of a Nixie clock. Now, I don't know if you guys know what that is, so I'll put a picture up on the screen, but this is a Nixie tube clock. It's like time in a glass bottle, and I'm really hoping the time almost looks like this on the weapon and it's constantly moving and counting up or counting down. That would be absolutely fantastic. We also have another calling card. This time it's depicting a witch, and she is not riding a broomstick. No, she is riding something much more powerful, a Barrett 50 cal, and that's always something that I can appreciate. Then finally, to wrap up week number two, we have the ability to get the character AJ from our drops, and of course, he will take the place of Warfighter. It looks like he's wearing his Letterman's jacket. Of course, it says IW on there, and you can see it looks like he's wearing jeans as well, which is a pretty nice character. And I think, once again, for week number two, this is going to be the most valuable thing you could get from the drops. Moving into week number three, we have a small change in our weapon variant. So taking a quick look at this, you can clearly see we have the Stallion 44, and then we have an Epic Auger that we're going to be able to get. Two more camouflages. One looks like a weird kind of spider webbing brush effect. The second one kind of looks like hands reaching up and trying to escape the weapon. The calling card is Frankenstein being energized back to life. And finally, we have Sally representing her outfit that she wore in Zombies in Spaceland. Looks pretty cool, and I think, once again, the character model is going to be the most valued thing out of everything in week number three. But now that we've gone through and talked about everything you have to find in supply drops, what about the absolutely free stuff that you're going to be given right away? So, starting in week number one, October 9th, we're going to get a free supply drop. Halloween hack number one is also going to be around until October 15th. Hack number one allows you to get Neil, the two weapon variants, and of course the camouflages I showed you here today. And of course, Carnage 24/7 and Double XP is going to be active until the 22nd, from October 12th to the 22nd. That's actually a very long time to try to grind out some ranks and get some prestige in. And then on Friday, October 13th, Friday the 13th, we're going to be given a free zombie ear accessory. So if you really wanted to, you can go on and just dangle around some ears on people. I don't know why anyone would want to do that, but I guess you have the opportunity if you really wanted to. Boss battle mode's also going to be introduced. Now, if you haven't had the opportunity to play the Easter egg in its entirety, and you really wanted to fight the alien from from Spaceland, or of course the giant brute from Raven the Redwoods, now is your opportunity. This mode allows you to jump in and jump straight to the boss fight. The downside to this is you don't get the reward. I'm under the impression you don't get the reward, at least. If you don't complete the entire Easter egg and then you just beat the boss, I think you just get rewarded with XP. But it's still cool. It allows you to experience that for people that want to kind of like gain traction on their enemy and of course learn their moveset. That way when you try to actually tackle the Easter egg, you know exactly what you need to do without going in blind. Moving on to week number two, you get a free supply drop once again, once it resets. And Halloween hack number two will be in line. I don't know why it says hack number one. Let me fix that for you, Infinity Ward. There we go. And on Friday, October 20th, you're going to get a free calling card and emblem. Raven the Redwoods will be leaving, but Spaceland, Shaolin Shuffle, and Attack of the Radioactive Thing will all be included for boss battles. So if you wanted to fight the Rat King, or of course the Radioactive Thing, you could jump straight to the boss fight. Week number three, you're going to get another free supply drop. Halloween hack number three will be in the picture. Carnage 24/7 will still be available, and it's going to be pushed all the way until November 1st. But the introduction of Quad Feed will be added as well. So Quad Feed is double XP, double weapon XP, double mission team XP, and double keys. That is going to be a lot of XP through the month of October. On Friday, October 27th, we're going to be given a free gravestone accessory. This is, of course, going to allow us to dangle the RIP off of our weapon and RIP some people of our own. And the boss battle is going to be switching gears to Director's Cut and the Beast from Beyond. And what I get from this is we're going to be able to fight the Rhino from the Beast from Beyond, and of course Mephistopheles, or the Devil from Director's Cut, which is pretty nice. Spaceland is going to be there all the time, so if you really want to fight that alien, you can definitely do it. And then finally, for week number four, on Monday, October 30th, right before the launch of World War II, we're going to have the ability to get a zombie character skin absolutely free. And I'm actually happy they did this, because when they showed the trailer originally and I saw that zombie, that was the only thing I wanted from it, and I'm glad that it's coming for free. I'm kind of sad that it's coming towards the end, because I would like to have a little more time to play with it, but either way, it is what it is, and that's going to wrap up the entirety, that is, Willard Wyler's Halloween Scream. Now, there's one thing that I absolutely would like to say, because something is just not adding up, and that is, of course, the weapon variants. There are going to be 6 total weapon variants put out there over the course of 3 weeks. However, if you guys remember a video I made from a couple of days ago, there were over 60 new variants found within the game's code, and they're completed. So I wonder just exactly what they plan on doing with all of those other variants. Throughout these next few weeks, are they just going to sprinkle them in, add them, of course, to the Quartermaster Collection and allow us to go to town? And the one thing that I really was hoping they'd do, at least for this specific event, was allow us to actually earn the axe. I mean, we've had that thing pretty much all year. Unfortunately, the only way to get it is through supply drops, finding it in the Quartermaster Collection. I don't know, maybe I was just hoping that they'd do something where you can get the axe, even if it was just a rare variant of it and you couldn't actually throw it like the epic variant. It would still be pretty cool, and it would make total sense because of the Halloween season. I mean, think about all of the horror movies where an axe is used to decapitate people. But it still makes me wonder if a majority of these weapons are going to be added directly to the Quartermaster Collection, meaning we're going to have to find them in supply drops, or are they going to be added directly to the Prototype Lab, meaning we can use our salvage that we've earned over the course of the past year to directly unlock weapons that we want. I think it wouldn't be too far-fetched to see them add more stuff throughout this, and of course announce new stuff to kind of bring people back in October, and try to keep people locked into Call of Duty Infinite Warfare at least until World War II rolls around. But we also have to remember, once World War II gets close to its release, people are going to get early copies, leaks are going to happen, leak live streams, and of course all the information is going to be out there. So most of the attention by October 30th is going to be drawn away from this game in its entirety. It's almost like that right now with all the hype that's around World War II, but I still think it's pretty commendable that Infinity Ward's taken the time to do this event when, in all actuality, they don't really need to do anything else at this point. It's great to know that they're still supporting people that support them, and I'm all aboard for that. As for the zombies portion, I'm ranked 250. I would really like to get to 500 before the end of this thing, so I'm hoping on Friday the 13th, double XP does come to zombies as well. If it doesn't, I'm going to be a little bit salty, but then again, I'll just stay in the multiplayer. lock down on some carnage, and of course, do what I gotta do. So anyway, guys, I hope you really enjoyed today's video. If you did, take a second of your time by clicking the like button down below. If you enjoyed this content and would like to see more of it, make sure to click that subscribe button as well. And if you're already subscribed, don't forget to join the notification squad, turn on the notifications, and be updated each and every day when my content goes live. Thank you all so much for watching, and until tomorrow's video, I'll see ya. Peace.